Okay, so we, most of you know that in Western Europe we use ESCC test method and guideline for radiation testing. ESCC, for people who are not familiar with means, I'm not sure, but European Space Component Coordination. Good. Okay. And this type of method are discussed in the radiation working group, that is one of the different working group of the CTB, that means Component Technology Board. Okay, I have it. Okay, so we have a SCE test guideline, that is the ESCC 25100. It has been updated 2 years ago, a little bit more recent. And we are working now on the 22900. It's not officially issued. Some points are still under discussion, but I thought it was a good idea to present it at this workshop. We don't have displacement damage guideline, but we are working on it, and tomorrow Thierry Nance from ONERA will talk about it. So this is the plan of my talks. I don't plan to present you all the specification. I will just present the changes. So I have adopted the color code. In blue, these are the new requirements, because we have new requirements. And in red, these are the requirements that have been modified or clarified. And if I have time, I will talk a little bit about TID variability and TID sampling size at the end. So starting with the section 4.2 of the specification, it's a table with a letter for the radiation harness for the manufacturer want to guarantee total dose harness in the frame of ESCC. So unfortunately, the letter do not fit with the 1000 letters, except for the 100 kilorad. We tried to change that, but it was complicated, so we decided not to change it. But what we changed is the requirement for the testing, so we still have minimum 3 steps, but instead of testing 3 times the dose of interest, we stop at 1.5 times the dose of interest. So this is an alignment with the 1000 standard for people who are familiar with. So this is one of the changes. Second changes was about the dose rate. So we still have the low dose rate window from 36 to 360 rad per hour. But the high dose rate has been changed. First, there was a gap between the low dose rate and the high, but there was no technical reason to do that. So the standard dose rate starts now at 360 rad per hour. And it has been also extended in the high range to fit the familiar 50 rad per second of the 1000 standard as well. We have also clarified the temperature requirement for the annealing at room temperature. Oh, this is, I don't know if I will read everything, but this is, I should remind you that the evaluation section of this test method is for manufacturers who want to evaluate a new process, new technology, or a new device. So first, if they have no idea of the total dose sensitivity of this product technology, they need to do an evaluation. And here, it's we describe a method to define if the part is sensitive to enhanced low dose rate. It's mostly concerned bipolar or BiCMOS technologies. And the idea is here to do a low dose rate testing and a high dose rate testing with a dose rate 2 order of magnitude higher than the low dose rate. And if the median deviation is within a factor of 1.5 between the two dose rate, we consider that the part is not sensitive to enhanced low dose rate sensitivity. Again, here it's an alignment with the 1000 standard, what they do in the 1000 spec. But we have also added, it was not in the spec before, that devices containing bipolar transistor and MOS element shall be evaluated both for elders and MOS specific effect. Sample size, we did not change that, expect some clarification. So it should be taken from different wafer and wafer location. The sample size for each unique set of tests shall be at least 5. It was not specified before. And test conditions shall include at minimum bias and unbiased. Before it was specified irradiation up to failure, it was a little bit vague. So we put a limit at 1.5 megahertz. I think it's good enough for most projects. Or up to the targeted ESCC RHA qualification level. Basically, if the manufacturer wants to guarantee 100 kilohertz, he can do it. His evaluation up to 1.5, this value. We have also clarified the post-electrical characterization because in the evaluation it was not specified, so 2 hours between two irradiation steps. And room temperature annealing, for people who are familiar with the evaluation specifications, there is 1 week of room temperature annealing, and the first measurement during this annealing was after 12 hours. It was not convenient at all because most of the time it was during the night. So we have pushed that to 24 hours. And also we have clarified the temperature requirements. There was no margin in the specification. Now we go to the second part of the specification that concerns qualification. So once the manufacturer has made the evaluation, he can start the qualification process if he wants. And also it concerns the radiation load testing that the manufacturer are performing on flight loads when they guarantee the radiation tolerance. So we put a requirement about testing at low dose rate for discrete bipolar devices. Sample size, we specify that minimum for each set of test condition 5 parts, bias and unbiased. 3 exposure, we talk about it, it was not. And now this is the main addition of this new issue because basically, the procedure was fit for the manufacturer to do the evaluation and the qualification of their product and then the load testing. But it did not fit very well with what is done very currently by industry is testing parts in the frame of a project when they buy parts that are not guaranteed by the manufacturer or not qualified. So this is what we add, a procedure. It's similar to the other procedure, but with some twist. So generally, here we specify the scope. You can read, you will be able to. So definition of test plans is similar to the, there is nothing new here. But we specify the low dose rate window for any device containing bipolar transistor. Sample size, still 5 minimum, but can be reduced to discuss. And we also need a control part, so nothing really new. Serialization as usual. After this test sequence is mostly the test sequence of the we have during the qualification in the previous issue. We just specify a minimum of 5 exposures. It was 3 in the qualification. And the standard sequence, 24 hours at room temperature, followed by 1 week at 100 degrees for the annealing. So the test report, what is new, it's about, because here we are talking about parts that either not qualified or not guaranteed by manufacturer, the radiation tolerance. And there are some specific requirements about the traceability of the part in a report. And it also includes the die pictures, and mostly for codes. And wafer lot number, but generally it's not known for codes or manufacturing facility. And the rest is typical of what we require in a test report. So just a slide to summarize the sample size requirement for total dose testing. So the ESCC for evaluation is 22 parts from 2 diffusion lot and 10 parts per diffusion lot. For qualification, it's 10 parts, 10 plus 1 control, and minimum of 5 samples per test condition. For the new section of SU5, it's also 5 parts irradiated plus 1 sample minimum. Just to remind you the mill, so for the qualification is 22 device or 2 device per wafer. And the another test method, maybe some of you are familiar with it, the STM F1892 requires also minimum 5 samples. I still have 10 minutes, that's okay. So we did a study with TIRAD about to study the variability of parts and the representativity of total dose testing when we were taking a sampling of 5 parts. So we chose very well-known parts that are used in most all spacecraft flying, especially the 2 first one, and maybe the LM-124 is the most tested part in the world. I should notice that this part are radiation hardened. It's coming directly from the space level that we have tested, so they are not cut. But we have picked this part because they are bipolar linear and they are first the most sensitive part now because the CMOS, new CMOS technology are basically not sensitive or basically not at the level we need for space. And also they show very large variability from part to part and load to load because mostly the total dose effect is based on the glassivation oxide that are not very well controlled by the manufacturer because they don't affect the performance of the part. So for each of these devices, you have tested 3 lots, 3 diffusion lots, and for each lot, 30 parts. And we have looked at the variability. Here, this is an example of one parameter for the ED584, the voltage reference. So you have the in gray, the degradation of the 30 parts. In blue, you have the medium variation among the 30 parts. And in red, you have the median minus 3 standard deviation in a sampling of 5 parts from the 30 parts. So you can see when you have a nice degradation, this plus minus 3 standard deviation on 5 samples is a good qualification, is a good bounding of the total dose degradation. We use 3 sigma because it's what is in a, we have a radiation hardness specification that specify when we do statistical analysis, we should guarantee a probability of 90% with a confidence level of 90%. And it corresponds when we test 5 parts to about 3 standard deviation. It's a little bit less, but so this is a good case. It works quite well. And here we have on the same example, I have shown so in red, you still have the standard sampling of 5 parts among the 30. And in green, you have the 5 best parts. And in blue, you have the 5 worst parts. So it's interesting to see that the 5 worst parts don't give a worse degradation, but the 5 best parts overestimate significantly the tolerance of the lot. So this, when everything goes well, but very often when you do radiation testing, you see parts going out of the typical degradation. So marginal, we call them marginal parts or mavericks. So this is the case here on this stem, the voltage reference. And again, it's a radiation hardened part qualified QMLV or I don't know. And see here you see among the 30 parts, you have 2 that are a little bit out of the distribution. So when by chance your sampling size takes one of these maverick in the test, you can bound also the degradation. But here this is the case where the sampling you have made of the 5 samples does not consider one of these 2 mavericks here. And in that case, you overestimate significantly the tolerance of the part. And also, in some case, you have a very large variability, and the limit at the median plus three standard deviation does not work very well. And we have a lot of examples like that. So just to give you an idea, this is not a very conservative approach, but this is. And here you have an example of LM124 offset voltage, the three lots that we have tested. The total dose tolerance, depending on what we consider. So in left, in brown, it's 30 parts, so it's a real value among the 30 parts that we have tested. In blue, light blue is the five best part. In orange after is the five worst. Dark blue, four best, because sometimes people also test four parts. The four worst in red, and after two selection of five samples in yellow and green, so for the different lot. And in, on the left, you have all the lot combined. And what is interesting also here, we look at the variability lot to lot, and you have the mean value plus or minus three standard deviation, the ratio between the lot for different parameters. So in this case, it's for the voltage reference, TL1431. And you can see that in a lot of occasions, the ratio between the different lots is greater than two. And you know that in a lot of projects, we consider that when we have a margin of two, we take care of the lot-to-lot variation. So it shows this is not always the case. So to conclude, we will issue soon a new issue of the ESCC 22900 that is addressing the need of industry to have really a specification that addresses the evaluation in the frame of a project. And so we have also tried to help the manufacturer to align the specification with the mill. So with one test, they can do a test that is valid for a mill qualification and also an ESCC qualification. And about sampling size, so five samples is adequate in most cases when the response is quite homogeneous. But it is not sufficient in case with large variability. And in that case, we would recommend to use mostly a sample of 10. And also, for the result of this study, for bipolar linear IC, lot-to-lot variation cannot be assured without testing. This is the result of the study. And I think Tirad is preparing a paper at RADx for this, about this study. Okay. Thank you for your attention.